Australia all out 143 and following on. That's the situation as Truman bows to McDonald. England 182 ahead and the Aussies in real trouble. The second inning score is only 10 when Truman dismisses McDonald. Laker bowling to Burke, and that's another. But now, in spite of all Laker can do, Harvey and Miller start to dig themselves in. The score creeps steadily upwards, and Harvey makes his half century. At the other end, Miller reaches 26. But at last, Laker gets the better of him, and he's caught by Truman at short leg. 108 for three, with the wicket getting more tricky all the time. Laker to Burge, who smacks him to the boundary for four. But that was a flash in the pan. Laker soon has him out LBW for five. 120 for four, and Laker's really getting into his stride. He dismisses Benno for a single, a disappointment for him after his 30 in the first innings. Laker to Johnson. And Johnson's caught at short leg, 136 for six. But while Harvey's still there, England may well have to bat again. It's Locke who bowls and catches him after a gallant innings of 69, exactly half the Australian score on the board. And now the collapse. Locke to Archer, who bangs him to mid-off, but Washbrook's there and catches him neatly. Maddox is out LBW for a duck. Soon Laker bowls Mackay with a yorker. Victory for England by an innings and 42 runs. Thanks above all to Washbrook, May, Laker and Locke.